Welcome back, friends. I am back for another installment of me playing through Oxygen Not Included in the thermal update. Now, interesting news, for certain values of interesting, the thermal update has now been published to the main branch. So if you have purchased Oxygen Not Included, your game has been updated with thermal, with the thermal update. You don't need to be on the preview branch anymore. That said, there have been only very minor bug fixes between the last publication to the preview branch and the update to the main branch. So much so that the differences are so small, in fact, that saves are cross-compatible, or they're they work. Saves from the preview branch continue to work in the main branch. And that's where we are now. So I've switched back to the main branch, and I am playing. I'm continuing the previous game. So, where were we? I can see we are in the middle of constructing some refrigerated storage for our food, and we are excavating up to here to get some venting from the cold air biome into our base. Oxygen seems to be okay. We're only oxygenating parts of the base that are that our dupes frequent. One thing I have noticed, after I asked some questions in the Oxygen Not Included subreddit, in environments that are sufficiently cold and airless, which is not the case here in my farm, but if this was full of carbon dioxide, for instance, food will not decay. The environment is considered sterile, and it can just sit there on the ground indefinitely, which is actually pretty handy. So I may install some gas permeable tiles, just so that the accumulated carbon dioxide can actually fill up these rooms and help increase the longevity of my food. That's one thing, and another thing I was wondering about, and maybe some of you have wondered the same thing. So the mealwood plant produces meal lice, these fruits that look like maggots and only move occasionally, according to the game. Meal lice can be eaten directly, or they can be processed here at the microbe musher into lice loaf. And of course, we can see here, this is what a lice loaf looks like. It looks a little bit like a compressed brick of maggots. Anyway, if you click on the lice loaf, you can see that, so this is a stack of five, and each of them is 1,000 calories. So the stack of five lice loaf is 5,000 calories. Whereas, well, there's no, so there's no meal lice here, but a fresh meal lice, or louse, that drops off the mealwood here, is 1,500 calories. So you may ask yourself, why would I cook these? Cooking a meal lice is plural, right? It's like head lice. So cooking a meal louse in the micro musher takes it from 1,500 calories to apparently 1,000 calories, and of course requires like man hours and also water and stuff. And so I ask, why would anyone cook these? Well, I learned something today, and hopefully you will too. So when one of the mealwood trees reaches fruition, it drops a pile of meal lice, but it's actually a pile of, I believe, 15 meal lice. So each time it drops something, you get 15 meal lice, which is at, or is it 10? Basically the point is, it is 10, okay. So, basically the point is, although each meal louse is 1,000 calories and the plant drops 15 of them at a time, the micro musher actually uses 5 meal lice per lice loaf bar. So in a single harvest of meal lice will give you 1,500 kilocalories of raw meal lice, but because it makes 3 lice loaves, each lice loaf actually requires 5 meal lice. So it produces 3 lice loaf bars for a total of 3,000 calories. And that's why you cook your meal lice. It actually doubles the yield. The aggregate yield. And of course they require atmospheric pressure, which is a bit low in the gardens. Okay, anyway, we're continuing to research advanced filtration, so I can start using things like gas filters. And the biodistiller are very important for turning slime into algae and water. Let them get on with it. We've actually run out of algae, so we're going to have oxygen production problems. Actually, if we have no slime, how are we going to produce oxygen? Do we have... Well, we certainly need an electrolyzer. So I will eventually get around to researching the electrolyzer after I research advanced filtration here. There have been minor changes, by the way, to the tech tree between the last preview build and the current contemporary build. So minor things have been swapped around in the research tree. Can't remember specifically what they are. But the patch notes are easy to find, either in the Steam pages or you can go to the Klei Oxygen Not Included forums. Anyway, it's all a work in progress. Alright, so we have completely researched the novice research portion of advanced filtration. We'll start on the intermediate research, which means I enable the supercomputer. I disable the research stations just to save a little bit of electricity. Now, the supercomputer gets really, really hot, which is why I built it closer to the ice biome. But all this rock will actually... It'll actually insulate. It'll actually make this area even hotter, which is why I need to start drilling into this... drilling a vent hole into the ice before my dupes start scalding themselves on the supercomputer. So one of the later revisions to the base game was the way heat radiates out from machinery. So up until quite recently, the last one or two patches back, machinery would heat itself faster than it would heat the environment, which is kind of the way heat actually works, or hot machines actually work. But of course, this was a problem for the game, because the supercomputer would get very hot, and it would scald dupes, which mean it was so hot it would injure dupes who were trying to use it. And the heat would not radiate away from the machine fast enough. So that's going to change. The way machines heat their environment has now changed. They will actually heat their surrounding environment faster than they heat themselves up, i.e. they heat radiates away from machines. Makes it a little bit easier to deal with, or its heat is certainly less concentrated anyway. Right, our two refrigerators here have no power. That's because... there we go. They should have power now. We had a gap in our wiring. Alright, why are all these meal woods stifled? Low atmospheric pressure. Yeah, I need some venting here. So, what I'm going to do... Let's see, we'll vent from these areas. And you can vent to the lower level. Where's our gas going? I should probably seal off areas that's I'm not using. Because basically it is spreading my existing gases out very... Oh, you know, I should probably take care of that oxygen problem first. Alright. So they have no algae. This is getting... Okay, I'm going to have to drill up here and harvest this algae. That should do us for now. In fact, I'm going to make that a priority because I believe my colony is suffocating. Let's see, I'll go to the priorities interface. Priority 9, i.e. highest priority. Do this before doing anything else. That is fine. As I said, I'm going to seal off this area, just so I'm not oxygenating Just so the paltry scraps of oxygen I do produce are not being spread out amongst this huge area, specifically areas where I don't need oxygen to be, so it can be concentrated in areas where my dupes actually are. Should have some cool air coming in from here to help cool down the hot, hot supercomputer. It's running very hot. Fair enough. Okay, so we should have enough algae for now. Alright, as soon as research is done, well, we're still researching advanced filtration there. Let's take a look at the water situation. We've got a small reservoir here, we've got a larger reservoir here, and we've got little drippings down at the bottom. So we're okay for water, I think. Let's see who we get for a new duplicate. Meep, Bubbles, and Herald. Both have pretty high, all of them have pretty high decor expectations, which is a minus. Loudsleepers. Loudsleepers are actually very easy to accommodate, but you have to make sure you remember to put their beds far away from everyone else. Diver's Lungs is a really good attribute to have. Naturally Robust is actually not that great. So dupes with Naturally Robust will tend not to get diarrhea and tend not to get the spores and other sci-fi diseases. But diseases, we tend not to see a lot of diseases anyway, so it's not as much of a plus as it might otherwise be. I don't mind taking Meep, I think. I'm going to take Meep, but I have to make sure I remember to build him a bed far away from everyone else. Actually, he's my 7th dupe, and I have only 5 beds. Alright. First of all, to the same effect, I believe I'm going to... Let's harvest the... Actually, I'm going to need a ladder up to there. I'm actually going to build a hatch so that, again, my precious gases don't... I'm not trying to aerate the entire world, right? So I'm going to build a hatch there. Build a hatch here. And where can I put a couple extra beds? Let's see. Also, that annoying whirring sound. I guess I have some power management problems as well. Alright, what's going on? Oh, my only source of power management is a single hamster wheel, which is woefully insufficient. Also, only one small battery. So I need more power generation. More power storage. Put a hatch here. So let's talk about power management for a second. With very little power storage, this manual generator is in use practically all the time because we're running out of stored energy and things are constantly needing energy, which means Meep, or whoever runs the treadmill, has to run it non-stop. If I'm able to build some power storage, and power can be stockpiled in excess of what we need immediately, and that means less time spent running on the treadmill and more time spent doing other things like digging. So that's why you want power storage, and you also want power generation. If I can put in more of these hamster wheels, more duplicates can simultaneously be generating power, which means if two duplicates, for instance, will generate the same amount of power as a single duplicate, but in half the time. I think that means they will be more, that's less overall time spent generating power, and again, more time spent doing other things, like tilling the compost heap, for instance. For that reason, I need somewhere, so I need some beds, need more hamster wheels, need power storage. Just the quick and easy solution for now is to excavate out some room for an additional bed or two here. And somewhere to put additional power installments. I'm still having still having atmospheric problems all over the base. And of course, Well, an additional oxygen generation problem is that there's not enough power to power all the oxygen generators. Okay, I think we've now reached crisis. Crisis situation here. Let's see, plumbing. This is a little bit messy, but I can tidy these up later if necessary. Okay. Meep has decided to fall asleep over here, beside the computers, because we don't have enough beds for everyone. So we can see by these like lighter colored blocks radiating out from his head, that's the noise radius. So anyone sleeping in that area will actually be awoken by his loud and obnoxious snoring, which interrupts their sleep, which imposes a penalty for them for the work they do the following day, and it's bad for productivity and so on. So of course, the only way I can pick where he sleeps is to build a bed and assign him to it and place that bed like far away from all the other sleepers. So that's what I'm going to have to do. I also need at least one more bed for a non-snorer. And look, we have some leakage from the water biome. So the ambient heat of here, basically, is warming up all this ice and polluted ice, and we're getting runoff. So water's pooling up here, and it's pouring all the way down here and into this convenient reservoir we have at the bottom. Let's harvest these. So if we take a look at this, for instance, meal lice. This one plant has just produced its harvest of meal lice, which is actually 15 of them. It's much better, particularly early in the game when you have plentiful water and probably energy. Except for me, of course, since I was a dummy when I set up the grid, to turn the meal lice into lice loaf bars. So I have a standing order here on the micro musher to turn any and all meal louses into lice loaf. Alright, so we have the second generator set up. Still think we need more power storage. So let's set up another battery in here. It's going to get very hot in there. Batteries, especially large batteries, generate a lot of heat. It's also very hot down here. Can't be very comfortable because it's like 40 degrees Celsius. I'll have to worry about ventilating that later. Huh, I've run out of seeds. I'm starting to run out of mealwood seeds. So if we expand the seed portion here, I don't have enough replacement seeds. So these things only harvest a finite number of times. Only produce food 3 times, I believe, per planting. At which point the plant dies, and then you have to reseed the planter box from your seed stores. Of course, that means you will eventually not have enough seeds to replace everything. However, we can raid this nice planty biome up here. Dig all of you up. I guess I'm going to need a ladder to get up there. And you're actually ready for harvest. Dig you up, and you, and you, and you, and you, and harvest you. This one is almost ready for harvest, as is this one, but I can certainly dig up these three. Ah, the bounties of nature. Some sort of inholy plant-like life form that grows on the lightless interior of an asteroid. Dig this out, just so my dupes have the headroom to move through. And in any case, we have plenty of kilocalories stored up. How are we doing for research? Okay, still plugging away at that advanced filtration. Still having oxygenation problems. I really need that percolation research. So, I don't really have a sustainable source of algae yet. But in the meantime, I really do need to generate more oxygen. Huh. I may as well just plug one in up here above the arch for now. So let's deconstruct. Say this one. I'll replace it with an actual buildable tile. So actually the main impediment to oxygen generation is not lack of algae, but inconsistent power to the grid. I'd hoped we would be a little better. Oh, we can see. Okay. So this is something particular to the thermal upgrade, or thermal update, in that circuits can now overload. So if you have too many things drawing power, circuits will become... The display shows them as being red. Before they turn red, they turn sort of amber as a warning. And basically what this means is my circuitry, my actual wires are now, and machines are now taking damage because of the poor quality of my electrical grid. One way to alleviate this is to build your wiring with heavy watt wire rather than electrical wire. It has a higher capacity for electrical load. And what that just means is it doesn't really matter on a structure by structure basis, but as you reinforce your entire grid with heavy watt wire, you'll be less prone to brownouts and electrical damage. So I'm going to start replacing my wires with this other heavy watt wire. It's like quadruple the cost of electrical wire. So electrical wire is nice and cheap for building early in the game. But as your grid gets more and more extensive, you need to start reinforcing it. So it doesn't look like I've done much, but if I go back out to here, we can see work orders are now in to upgrade existing wire with sturdier wiring. So we have a bit of an oxygen crisis. We're having a bit of an electrical supply crisis. But otherwise, we're doing fine, I think. Stress is low. We've got plenty of food. We do need more algae. I mean, this little bit here is not going to last us very long. Which is why I actually need to get started on the slime facility. Slime, and in particular the biodistiller, is very handy. It turns slime into algae, which you turn into air. And slime also turns into, as part of that process, it also produces water, which is also another vital resource. So we'll let the dupes get on with what they're doing. I wonder how much metal I have. Okay, I've got a fairly large amount of metal with which to upgrade the wiring. I think we need to prioritize this battery sooner rather than later. Do I have enough dupe? Raw minerals in here for the... Okay, I'll just dump this out on the ground. So the storage compactor is no longer allowed to contain raw minerals. So it dumps it out on the ground, which means the hatch I have in here will have plenty of food. In retrospect, I may have expanded a little bit too fast, a little too ambitiously. Basically, there's more work than I have dupes to support. It or to perform them in a timely fashion. Anyway, I needed at least two more beds, so one of them will go here, and then I need... Oh, let's take a look at this. We've completed advanced filtration, and we really, really need percolation. Also, we have started on the biodistiller. Percolation, here we go. Alright, I need one... last place to put a bed for a noisy sleeper. Oh, well, night has fallen, so we're not getting any beds built at the moment. But for future consideration, let's see. Want it to be well oxygenated, but also far away from other sleepers. For instance, Meep has fallen asleep here. Not on a bed, just near several beds. And of course, these dupes are constantly being interrupted by his snoring. The sleep of my dupes. That is terribly inconvenient. They're going to wake up and have had a terrible night's sleep and be grouchy and inefficient and stressed. You know what? I'm just going to... I'll tidy this up later, but I really need to put that bed somewhere else. Alright, I'm going to build a bed up here. And Meep can sleep in it. Okay, I think our power generation problems should now be resolved. Nope. I'm still going to have to do some reinforcement. I have reports of circuit overloads. So circuit overloads can, over time, they can manifest as actual broken circuits, like the wiring I've hidden inside these tiles. It can just break, which means everything downstream doesn't have power. It can cause actual damage to your machines, which is sometimes even worse, because the machines themselves then require power. And they can consume a lot of resources. They require a lot of resources in repair, and those resources tend to be metal, which is a fairly precious commodity. I mean, it's a finite commodity, right? This is a little bit... there we go. Can't see which parts of the wiring need reinforcement until I have a brownout. There. That should be enough to keep my dupes busy for quite some time. And in fact, I should probably set them to mine out this ore. So, well, the air is sufficient, but it's not great. Oh, that's right. I'm going to build a tile here. Oh, even better, a gas permeable tile. And on that tile, I will build an algae deoxidizer. It's going to consume... we're going to be consuming algae at an even faster rate. Can't really be helped, though, because we need the air. I'll hook you into the existing grid. Building entirely from heavy wad wire. See where else I can reinforce. Okay. Alright, hopefully that will do it. What this tells me is, of course, I can't really expand this grid any further. I'll want to create a... if I build a lot more machines, I'll want to build another... like, start a new grid and isolate it from this one. So the electrical load... basically, this grid can't handle any more load. So if I want more electrical appliances, it'll have to be a separate grid. All that said, I think we're on our way. The colony is still reasonably stable, and we're solving the problems as we find them. You'll note, though, that we haven't been expanding as much because I had to... typically when I play, I expand, and then I have to fix all the problems that expansion created. Then I expand again, fix, expand, fix, expand, fix. And in that way, my colonies become weird and monstrous, like rat mazes, weird tubes and wires everywhere. Not elegant. Okay, so I think I'll end this one here. Thanks for watching me bumble through Oxygen Not Included. Again, the thermal update, has gone live. It's now published to the main branch. Oxygen Not Included is in a pre-alpha early access state. Nowhere near done. Features are being added, balance and bug fixes are going on. It's in reasonably good shape, like it's playable and it's fun, and I look forward to new stuff. It's being developed by Klei Entertainment. You can purchase the game through Steam, but you'll have to find a link on the Klei Entertainment forums to do so. Yeah, that's the game. My name is Alfred. Thanks very much for watching. I will catch you next episode.